This is Amanda.
The first time I was homeless, I was 11 years old, and the second time was when I was 14. My entire childhood was characterized by the fear of us losing our home. My father was a very hard worker, but even the long hours that he used to put in were not enough to keep our family afloat, so he got a second job, and shortly after that, he had a quadruple bypass. He was unable to work, and he lost his purpose for life, and they gave him pain medication, which very quickly he became addicted to, and that addiction transformed him into a completely different person. All I remember is my mom saying, pack everything you can as quick as possible. A car came and picked us up and drove us to the Lorena shelter. I noticed the chain link fences and the bulletproof windows and the cameras. And despite those restrictions that were there to keep us safe, that was the most free I had felt in my entire life. When I got here, my mom and I both had stuffed animals on our cots. And this was the one that was on mine. And it's a sheepdog that I've kept with me ever since. When you are living in a life of fear and deprivation, you really notice the small things. And a small thing like the sheepdog was life-changing for me.
In fact, her entire experience at the shelter was transformative.
It showed me that there was a life outside of the one that I had been living for so long. It gave me a window into what could be. So when we left the shelter, my mom and I found an apartment. And within a few months, she did end up back living with my father, wanting to keep our family together. But I realized within a couple of years that this just was not a safe situation for me. And I asked her if she wanted to leave with me. I told her that we could go together and that I would wait for her, and she said she couldn't. And shortly after, I made the decision to leave home myself.
At the age of?
14. At first, you know, I was able to find a few places to stay, couches to sleep on, and then the street outside. Mostly it was park benches. Eventually I had to make the difficult call to contact the police. And I remember it was snowing that day. It was just too cold. So they placed me in a foster home, and then I was placed in another one shortly after. Ended up at one where I stayed for a few years until I ended up moving out on my own.
And things got better?
You probably want a yes. The answer's no. Living on my own in high school is the epitome of the periphery of homelessness. It was very challenging. I was working three jobs just so I could go to a school where I couldn't keep my grades up. And I said, I have to move forward and do what it takes to get out of this. I did. I started post-secondary. And I just kept going. I did a first degree, then a second degree, and started writing and met the love of my life and have two beautiful, very healthy, happy children. Met a hockey game one day, and I'm just talking to the lady beside me, and it turns out she works for the Lorena shelter. And she said that they were having a gala coming up and that they needed a speaker. So I said, yeah, let me put my attention to that. And so
she began speaking to people, telling them her story.
I like them to see firsthand that the changes they make, that the help that they give, small or large, makes a difference. If you were to ask me what event helped bring me to where I am today, I couldn't narrow it down to any one big thing. It's the little things that added up. Help from the food bank, the Lorena shelter. Okay, so we're in my daughter's room, and this is Lucky right here, sleeps with her every night. I mean, the person who bought it probably didn't think twice, maybe, about where it would end up or what it would mean, but it has been the most amazing gift I've received in my life. There's a reason he's got the name Lucky. Every individual act builds up almost like a snowball, and it forms a community. And when we have a community, there's nothing that we can't do.
The unstoppable Amanda Dauvin and Lucky.